So good morning, everyone. In the last presentation, you heard a lot from Helder about involvement and a lot of the students saying get involved and, you know, take advantage of everything you can on campus. He didn't specifically touch a lot about what involvement meant, so hopefully I can shed some light on that term and the factors that actually affect that. So if you know anything about me, you know that I am a very involved student, per se. I participate in a lot of extracurricular activities. So basically, the idea for this project came from those involvements. At Bridgewater, we have a high population of commuter students. Sometimes we seem to have a tough time getting those students involved and engaged in extracurriculars at the university. So basically, extracurricular involvements are stressed on campus because research has shown that involvement can have a very strong and significant impact on the development of students. Alexander Astin defines involvement as the amount of physical and psychological energy that a student devotes to the academic experience. His theory for student involvement is really the basic theory behind this presentation. For the purpose of this particular project, I define extracurricular involvement as any type of voluntary participation in an on-campus club, organization, student government, Greek organization, varsity athletic team, intramural or club sport team, community service, and any other type of extracurricular activity that is not purely academic in nature and for which the participating student does not receive monetary compensation. It is very clear to note that the actual theory of involvement is an overall concept in the terms of engagement. So all those things that I listed in my definition all form a part of involvement. So basically, participating in more activities and organizations and holding offices increases involvement. There are many types of extracurricular activities which a student may partake on campus. So it's unclear whether one particular type of involvement has more significant effects than others. However, Astin has found that any type of involvement is very significant to learning and student development. Along with more involvement in extracurricular activities, there seems to be a positive correlation between involved students and residing on campus. Astin has found that students who have resided on campus were a lot more likely to be satisfied with the overall undergraduate experience. So students living in the residence hall persisted and graduated at significantly higher rates than students lacking the residential experience or commuters. It has been found that students living on campus then turn better grades and have higher retention rates at their institutions are better than their off-campus peers. Retention rates at a university are directly related to how satisfied a student is with a university. In 1993, Astin shows that the higher the levels of satisfaction, the higher the students' retention rates are higher to be. So basically, place of residence has been shown to have a huge impact on student development and involvement. Residents are more likely than commuters to achieve in extracurricular areas as leadership, athletics, and to express satisfaction with their undergraduate experience, particularly in the areas of student interaction, faculty relations, and social life. The findings for commuter students are significantly different. Astin found that the more time a student spends commuting to campus, the more negative effects it has on certain aspects of student development. The more time students spend commuting, the less time reported negative impact on retention and attainment of the bachelor's degree, growth in leadership abilities. Also very important, the less they join extracurricular organizations or get involved, if you will. It seems basically that all the positive effects are related to living on campus while the negative effects are related to commuting. This particular finding is actually very important for the research because it is assumed that the more time a student actually spends commuting, the further they are living from campus. So basically, this project takes place to kind of fill the void with that part of it. So all of these findings have depended solely on whether the student lives on campus, at home, or at an off-campus apartment. I want to look specifically at how distance from campus in terms of miles affects that, that a student has to travel affects certain variables of student involvement and satisfaction. So by asking the series of questions on the screen in relation to other variables, I asked a total of 12 questions branching from all areas of student development, but I chose these five to present today because of time. So you can see up on the screen, what is the relationship between distance from campus and a positive answer to the statement, I would still come back and finish my degree work here after all of my experiences? What is the relationship between distance from campus and a level of involvement scale, which I will present further on? What is the relationship between distance from campus and the self-reported happiness with the overall BSU experience? What is the relationship between distance from campus and the feeling of being connected to Bridgewater State University community? And what is the relationship between distance from campus and GPA? Of course, you can't do a project involving a university without looking at grades. The answer to these questions will help give some new evidence in the case of Bridgewater State University to better figure out how we can get students more involved and what we can do to specifically target commuter students to be more involved in extracurriculars and therefore be more satisfied with the overall extracurricular experience. So in order to complete this project, I had to go through a process of actually surveying using spatial analysis or geographic information systems to look at the trends and creating two different numbers. So for the survey, a total of 200 items were actually asked to survey participants about residency status, demographics, family background, high school information, academic information, involvement, and students' perceptions and values of the college experience. Specifically, the survey asked participants to provide an address with a street intersection so that the distance from campus could be calculated using that address they provided to the Bridgewater State University address. Survey questions regarding some of their attitudes regarding university, peers, and satisfaction with the experience were asked in a 1 through 5 scale, so 1 being not at all and 5 being a great deal to whatever the variable was. The spatial analysis part of it was actually a little bit tricky. It took quite a bit of effort. I used ESRI ArcGIS software with the addresses that were obtained from the survey to create 2 geocoded layers with attributes and variables containing the survey. So basically what a geocode is taking the actual address that they provided and putting it on the map. After that, I received a distance from campus, which is basically just a number in terms of miles. And this was actually the final result of it. So as you can see up there, every point is basically a geocoded address that was found. So the little red cars are commuters from home. The little blue houses next to the Bridgewater are off-campus residents. And there is only 1 point for Bridgewater because there's only 1 address. You can see that 234 on-campus residents responded, 13 off-campus apartment residents responded, and 26 commuters from home. I thought that was going to be a sign of things to come, basically showing the difference in the level of involvement. So as I mentioned earlier, I actually used a scale. I call it a level of involvement scale, or lowest for short. I thought that was witty. So basically, because there isn't enough time, it's a sum of all the participants' extracurricular involvements. So basically, if a student said they participated in any activity, they received 1 point for it. If they said they were a member of the ski club, that was one point. If they said they participated in community service, that was another point, all the way up to as many points as possible. All right, so looking at the questions now. So what is the relationship between distance from campus and the level of involvement scale? So you can see that there is a negative correlation. Students who have a lower distance from campus. So basically what that means is that students who live closer to campus do tend to get more involved. And you can see the difference with this map compared to the other map. Self-reported happiness with the BSU experiences. So there is a negative correlation. It's not very significant, but it is negative. So you can see this one. Response with a high degree of satisfaction with the overall BSU experience. So once again, the little cards are starting. Basically, it actually turned out to be the opposite of what I hypothesized. The further the student lived from campus, the more positively it affected grades. So students who live further away from campus tend to have higher grades.